Hi and welcome to the channel. So today I will present to you the benchmarks for this AFAX GTX 750 Ti and at the end if I would recommend this GPU or not. If you haven't watched my unboxing yet, you may want to watch it first before watching this benchmark. In that video, I estimated that GTX 750 Ti should be slightly stronger than the GT 1030. So let's check if it's true. But first, let me tell you about the test bench specs. I am using a Ryzen 3 3100 for the processor on a B450 Ioros M motherboard with 16GB 3200MHz dual channel RAM. All games are in 1080p unless stated otherwise. For CSGO on auto high settings, GTX 750 Ti had 99fps while GT 1030 had 84fps, making GTX 750 Ti 17% better than the GT 1030. For Valorant on medium settings, GTX 750 Ti had 177fps while GT 1030 had 150fps, making GTX 750 Ti 18% better than the GT 1030. For Dota 2, on the best looking settings, GTX 750 Ti had 58fps while GT 1030 had 60fps, making GTX 750 Ti 3% weaker than the GT 1030. Just take note that 2 to 3fps difference is usually within the margin of error. Thus, GT 1030 and GTX 750 Ti might be of equal footing in this game. For Fortnite, on high settings, although GTX 750 Ti had 137fps and GT 1030 had 130fps, these are considered invalid results as the game CPU bottlenecked with Ryzen 3 3100. Meaning, if I plug in a stronger processor, I could squeeze more performance from these GPUs. For FF14 benchmark on high laptop settings, GTX 750 Ti had 47fps while GT 1030 had 36fps, making GTX 750 Ti 30% better than the GT 1030. For reference, I also have benchmarked the game on standard settings. For FF15 benchmark on low settings, GTX 750 Ti had 31fps while GT 1030 had 25fps, making GTX 750 Ti 24% better than the GT 1030. This also makes the GTX 750 Ti the cheapest entry-level card that you can buy now to play this game. For Shadow of the Tomb Raider on low settings, GTX 750 Ti had 37fps while GT 1030 had 28fps, making GTX 750 Ti 32% better than the GT 1030. This also makes the GTX 750 Ti the cheapest entry-level card that you can buy to play this game. For Forza Horizon 4 on low settings, GTX 750 Ti had 37fps while GT 1030 had 39fps, making GTX 750 Ti 5% weaker than the GT 1030. Just take note that the 2 to 3fps difference is usually within the margin of error. Thus, you can consider GT 1030 and GTX 750 Ti of equal footing in this game. For Far Cry 6 on low settings, GTX 750 Ti had 24fps while GT 1030 had 16fps. And although that means that GTX 750 Ti is 50% better than the GT 1030, the game is still unplayable at 1080p with GTX 750 Ti, at least in my opinion. No? Overall, GTX 750 Ti performed well. On average, it performed 15% better than the GT 1030, even if I considered it's supposed to be negligible losses from Dota 2 and Forza Horizon 4. If I ignore those two games and consider them as erroneous data, GTX 750 Ti is on average 21% better than the GT 1030. So from a price to performance standpoint, I think lugi ito at 6K if I compare it with the GT 1030. Siguro at most, I would recommend GTX 750 Ti if it is priced at 5.5K at most. No? And on top of that, there are other issues that we have to address with this card other than its price. First is its lifespan. I did read two comments citing concerns that this is already out of support. So I did try to check Nvidia's website to see if I can still be given the latest drivers, which they still provide. This is because GTX 750 Ti uses a newer architecture compared to other 700 series chipsets. I did not run into problems like missing shaders or missing DirectX features, at least on my perspective, hindi ko talaga alam kung missing ba yung textures since kompleto naman yung details. And so, hindi talaga ako sure if problem ba siya ngayon or hindi. Pero posibleng in the next year or two, wala na itong driver support and therefore, pwede ka na magka-problema sa newer games. Pero if you're just going to play classic esports titles, then that shouldn't be a problem, no? Likely it would still run in the next 2 to 3 years or so. And if you're planning to play future AAA titles on this card, then hindi mo actually problema yung missing DirectX features or missing shaders. Ang problema mo na is kung kaya pa ba nung GPU na to na makarender at 30 FPS for newer games. Which I doubt, no? Looking at Far Cry 6 data. Second is that it's really out of production. This card, as seen in my unboxing, the QC date was August 2018, which means na 3.5 years na itong nasa shelf. And finally is its brand, AFOX. So AFOX is really unknown to me. I have no prior experience from it, and so I have an unknown amount of risk. Again, if you know this brand, do leave a comment down below. So personally, given its performance over GT 1030, and let's say no, it costs the same as the GT 1030, I simply wouldn't buy this card given that risk alone. It's an unknown brand with an unknown amount of risk that I am not willing to take. Pero siguro kung may mga known brands, no, like Gigabyte, Asus, MSI, probably Colorful, may release sila ng GTX 750 Ti, bago talaga at hindi noong 2018, I could consider this card at 5.5k pesos. More than that, I think overpriced na. Lastly, I tested this GPU for streaming. This card really has an NVENC encoder. Pero I think 8 years old na yung NVENC encoder na to. So I did have a 25 FPS drop when streaming Valorant. So it's not like the newer NVENC encoders na 0 FPS drop. Ang masasabi ko lang is kahit may FPS drop ito, feeling ko lang mas less yung input lag as compared to whenever I use my CPU as encoder. Feeling ko lang naman since wala talaga akong pansukat ng input lag. So that's it for this video. I hope you learned something. Thanks for watching. Do like or dislike, comment on what you think, and subscribe for more unboxing and benchmarks. Bye!